the key thing to have this high performance electronic devices is to keep these things cool. And to keep these things cool, we really need to have some advanced thermal solutions. But the key change which has happened in the last decade or so is additive manufacturing, or the age of 3D printing. It enables you to come up with innovative designs, design something which was previously not thought of.
We sat down as a team coming up with ideas. One of our contributing factors was keeping things natural. So we have a shark fin design.
We need to introduce structures which can reduce the drag. And that's how we take the inspiration from the shark fins. Basically allow the air to swirl inside. And because the air spends a longer time inside, it gets more time to take the heat out. One of the key inspirations from that part is our human body system. So as our human body system kind of operates, we breathe in air and we breathe out air. And that's how the respirator kind of originated.
The point of the swirlers and the respirator and having those three separate stages is to optimize heat transfer at the entrance of the heatsink to refresh the air in the middle, and then to optimize the heat transfer in the latter half of the heatsink.
As we saw later in the competition, none of the other teams had that design, and even the judges said that this is a very unique and smart thing to do. Heat sinks of the top six teams were printed by GE and tested.
The actual results turned out to be much, much better than what we thought about. Performance-wise, we were like much better. Cost-wise, we are like much lower.
I just was like, oh, we won! Because everybody in my department knew that I was waiting for the news. Pretty exciting.
Taking nature-inspired structures and translating them to something that can be manufactured with this process was difficult in some ways and required a lot of rethinking the design and translating that. It was a very fun process and it resulted in something that I'm very proud of.
And it feels really nice and empowering to come from Purdue, kind of stand on the same platform as them and finally emerge out as winners, I would say.
Purdue having all these different kinds of research here, you go downstairs and there's a whole other group of people that you can collaborate with, was something that really allowed us to succeed.